Comfortable to just be on the floor? Okay. Your volunteers have found her, and how are you?
And so.
So that arm goes.
You're not gonna wanna be here because.
You're not gonna be able to move that arm.
So this gets rolled up.
Don't you put their arm up in the air first?
It's up.
The other one is.
So this is.
Down on the side.
But he's holding her. She's not resting on her arm.
Okay, now, roll her back onto the tarp. And pull the tarp out from under her on this side. These backboards have a head and a foot. So is that.
Get one more volunteer over here.
So this is the head.
Awesome.
It says head.
Head.
He's gonna have to get in there where you're at.
Two, three.
Watch your knee over there.
Okay, you're over there. On my count, we're gonna put her down. Is anybody not lower to the ground? Anybody not ready? One, two, three.
Now, one of the advantages of her being on the tarp is that you're probably going to have to slide her a little bit farther toward the head.
Yeah,
so you can pull her and get her adjusted such that she is toward the head, maybe just a slight bit more, another inch or two. That's good. Okay, the question now is, do we want her hands inside or outside of the tarp?
Inside.
Depending on her injuries, depending on the weather, and depending on her level of comfort and claustrophobia. Let's put her on the outside. And the reason I'm going to make this decision is that it's pretty warm in here, and she's going to get way too warm. Now, we should put some padding underneath her.
Yeah.
So let's lift her up again. On my count of three, we're going to just lift her up to your knee. Is anyone not ready? One, two, three. And below her knees, the tarp here, if you can see it, that'll go above her knee. And
yeah, it goes under the knees.
And this will go under the small of her back. So we didn't plan very well ahead, did we?
No.
Okay. So we'll lower her to the ground and make sure that she is positioned such that the space under her knee and the space in the small of her back are over those pads. Is anyone not ready? One, two, three. Okay, how does the victim feel? Is that okay? He's got a thumbs up. Okay. Before we had done this, if we had suspected spinal injury, cervical injury in particular, we would have had somebody holding manual traction or manual stabilization on her head to make sure we didn't do that.
Yeah.
Once we get her on the board, we're going to need to do that also permanently. There are a number of different techniques to do that.
Though it went too back that far, and if there was a void, they would put something small on there.
Not quite the same.
The board was coming alive, the same as the sheet. So that goes there. and then roll it up.